Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to episode number 195 here on season number 2. And today we are getting into Stash Retire Recap September edition. So these videos are meant for educational purposes only and not meant to be taken as financial advice. You're responsible for your assets and to properly protect them. So always please do your own research. I had an interesting turn of events this month with Stash Retire. Last month, my Stash Retire account, as you probably already know, lost to my Stash Invest account by about 13%. However, this month, my Stash Retire account lost to my Stash Invest account by almost 1%. Actually, to be more specific, it was 0.89%. We could just round up and say like 1%, right? Something along those lines. So it is kind of interesting because like 3 months ago, my Stash Retire account was like completely crushing my Stash Invest account. But now it seems like it's starting to flop. And I don't know if that's because I was buying more into Park My Cash with my Stash Retire account like 3 or 4 months ago. And now I'm buying more into Park My Cash with my Stash Invest account. I honestly don't really know. I don't have a like good explanation on why one dropped negative this month and one went positive this month. I'm still a little bit confused on that. But as far as my 5 target positions go, 3 out of those 5 have already been achieved, like they were in basically, I think, the last 2 videos. Delicious Dividends is at 25%. Park My Cash sits at 26%. Real Estate Tycoon is sitting at a 17%. Robots Rising this month actually, I believe, hit, I want to say 9%, possibly even 10%, but since the recent drops in the market, it now sits around 8% of my overall account. The nice thing is that like over the probably the next like 1 to 2 months, I should have that Robots Rising at 10%. And obviously that since I don't have 10% in the Robots Rising, that means I don't have any single stocks, but it is kind of nice like to finally see some light at the end of the tunnel that eventually I'll be able to own a little precious single stock. I don't know what the heck happened there. As far as the gross on the account this month, it is $27.97, which is down from last month at $40.69. But if you take away the two $15 deposits that I made, you get a net loss of $2.03, or a negative 0.31%. Last month, I was positive $10.69, or 1.72%. And in case you want to know, about 2 months ago, I was positive $8, or 1.90%. The year-to-date return on my Stash Retire account is 4.67%, or around $25.29. This is still my second best performing account to date, I guess second to my Stash account, which is a little bit irritating because even last month, it was actually still my top performing portfolio. At the close of this month, my account was over 6.55% positive. However, over the last 2 weeks, you'll see when I pull it up, it's started to decrease quite a bit. I feel like that's a perfect segue and go ahead and looking at our actual account. So if you look on the screen here, this is my Stash Retire account. Right now I sit at 2.7%. So as you can tell, we've lost about 4.5% in the market over the last like 5 to 6 days. We'll go ahead and go look at the portfolio right now. You can tell 26% Park My Cash, 25% Delicious Dividend, 17% Real Estate Tycoon, 16% Moderate Mix. That'll continue to go down as I continue to not put money in there. That was just something that I put money into when I opened my account. Robots Rising sits at, hey, a 9%. See, I told you it was at 10% at one point, I believe, last month, but then it kind of just dropped off. You know what I mean? My balance, as you can tell, I have green tops, and green tops make the rings drop. What does that even mean? Anyways, green tops for me are good. I don't want to see any red because I don't want to be withdrawing my money. And obviously, if a green plus a white does not beat a white bar the next month, it's all right. Sometimes there is market fluctuations and that does happen. Let's go ahead and take a look at the account history right quick. There shouldn't be that much here besides maybe some dividends and some investments. Right here, I got a reinvested dividend into Park My Cash for 31 cents. My $15 deposit on the 10th, which I bought Park My Cash. The subscription payment for $2 on the 13th. I wish that they would change that to like the same way that Stash Invest is, where it comes out on the first of the month. That would be really, really awesome. $15 on September 20th, which I purchased some Robots Rising. I reinvested that 5 cents into Wireless Wonders, a $1.36 from Real Estate Tycoon. That's nice. That almost covers the fee for this month. And then also another $1.14 from Delicious Dividends. And then moving into next month, obviously you can tell some payments and some dividends and all the like. That is pretty much my Stash Retire account in a nutshell. It's not really too complicated on what my strategy is. If you want to check that out, I can upload my Stash Invest strategy for 2018 up in the corner up here. I'll try to remember to do that. But I'm still excited to see. It's just for me, it's just such a bummer that like this used to be my best performing account and now it's not. I think honestly it has to do with the $2 versus the $1 that I'm paying to Stash to hold those accounts. So for Stash Invest, it's only $1 per month. For Stash Retire, it's $2 per month. And one is like almost double in size. So my Stash Invest account is around $1,400 to $1,500. My Stash Retire account is around $600. So obviously, even just by the nature of the beast, I'm paying four times as much for my account, or four times the percent of what I would be paying on my Stash Invest account on my Stash Retire account, if that makes any sense at all. So if I was paying $2 for my Stash Invest account, we'll say it was at, like, for the sake of math, $1,500 or it was $1,400. If it's my Stash Invest account or my Stash Retire account, I was only paying $1 per month, it would have to be at $700 in order for me to be paying the same exact percent. Does that make sense? So honestly, on my Stash Invest account, I'm paying a whole lot less per month than I am on my Stash Retire account, which I do understand why that is. It's just unfortunate that my Stash Retire account seems to be suffering when I compare it to my Stash Invest account, but it'll all pan out once there gets more money moved over to my Stash Retire account for sure. Anyways, we will go ahead and leave right there. Let's jump into the question of the day really quickly, which is if you could hear every time someone said something good about you or something negative about you, which would you choose? This is a very, very interesting question. My wife and I were actually talking about this, I think yesterday or 2 days ago. We were like, it would be awesome to kind of hear like people's negative thoughts about you, like so that way you like constructive criticism, not like, oh man, I hate that person, but like actual constructive, you know what I mean? Like, okay, like here's something that I didn't like, and it's like, okay, like, oh, well, I can fix that or whatever. Like, it would be nice to hear those negative comments because I'm like, I can go get positive if I need positive. Like, I got people that will just feed me the positive, but I want to hear like the critics. I want to hear what's not good about something, like what's not good about the video, what's not good about this, what's not good about that. Because honestly, like I'll be honest, I'm more of a positive person trying to look at things. And so most of the time I'll just look past the negative because I don't want to see it, or I just don't innately see it. And so it's nice to have someone, hey, like, did you see that spot right there? And you're like, oh my gosh, like, wow, now it really sticks out like a sore thumb. Thanks, my man. You know what I mean? Like something along those lines. So I'm still torn, but I think I would flow more towards the negative hearing about me, and I would try to, I guess, do my best to use it as constructive and try to turn it into a positive to, I guess, make me a better person. So like I always say, if you got a question regarding Stash, Acorns, Robinhood, M1 Finance, as well as general investing, business, Etsy, coaching, please post those questions down below. Don't forget to subscribe right up here. Check out these two videos right here and the link right here. And as always, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it.